Hey, welcome back to the workshop. It's been a while since I've done a video like this, and I'd like to do them more often. I have a huge assortment of kits that came in, and all of these are going to get built. So don't put in the comments, I wish you would build the... All of these are going to get built over time. Two videos per week. It takes a while, but we're going to get to everything you're going to see. Let's take a look at what we're going to have coming up in the channel, on the channel, and then I'm going to be building up for you to see. First up, let's show off the Revell Germany Level 5 1/25th scale, 231 parts, 32.4 centimeters. You can easily do the conversion online. Kenworth W900. That is an outstanding kit. It's another reissue with some sweet murals for the cab and the sleeper. It's got gorgeous chrome accents, 231 parts, like I said. That is going to be a fun one to put together, and you can expect to see that on the show really, really soon. I'm going to have to keep dropping stuff down lower to keep showing it off. From AMT, reissue of the Italeri kit, 1/24th scale, 40-foot container trailer. This is going to be an outstanding accessory to the Italeri tractor that I built a while ago. It's going to be pretty sweet. You'll be able to check it out. This thing has got a lot of detail on it. It's got the detachable container. It's got the wheels. It's got landing gear that you can actually set as you want. So you can have it hooked up to a rig, or you can have it standing on its own. I've already built the reefer trailer that you saw on the show, and I've already built the long hauler tractor. Now we'll get to build the cool 40-foot container that goes behind it. Maybe I'll even have some fun. I've never seen these things in pristine condition coming off a train or a cargo ship, so maybe I'll get to weather this bad boy up when I get to it. Now, we're going to change up a little bit. Atlantis sent over some cool kits recently. We got their Stalin tank. This will be an excellent companion to the other tank that I built for them recently. It's got the 122mm gun. It's got flexible tank treads. I love rubber band style tank treads in model kits. I don't have a problem weathering them and beating them up, and it's going to be fun to put together. You can take a look at a completed model on the box and the illustrations there, so that's pretty cool. Also, they sent over the 8-inch howitzer. So this could be a companion to the M48 that I put together. This one is trailerable. It's got it in its towing and its firing capacity. It's an awesome kit. Old school, molded in green, and that's going to be a fun one to put together as well. What else? Should we just keep grabbing kits? These things are stacked three deep, so hold on, folks. It's going to be a nice long video, and you've got nowhere to go anyway, so why don't you watch? Just in, this just came in yesterday in the mail from Monogram, the Chevy Love Street Pickup, 1/24th scale. Check it out. Molded in the USA now. It's got 73 parts, molded in white with vinyl parts. It's going to have the V8 engine. It's going to be the sporty option, detachable topper. Can't wait to get this bad boy built up and check out those gorgeous decals. They're going to be in there when we take a look at it. We'll put that one down. What do we grab next? Right out of the center, the King. Yes, Salvinos JR latest kit, the 83 Pontiac Grand Prix, sent over by Model Roundup. Molded in the USA. You know I love these old stock car kits, and check it out. We're going to get that beauty built up for you as well. And this one is in the older 1/24th style scale. Can't wait to get that paint on there. Get those decals, those tire decals. You know I love the Salvinos kits. Off to the side, back on the screen, the 69 Plymouth GTX Hardtop Pro Street from AMT, 1/25th scale. Check out the options in the box there. This was sent over by Round 2. And these kits are actually out right now, so if you go and order it from Model Roundup, you'll be able to check it out. Check out the new decal sheet. On the back, we got all the parts, but we always show all the parts in my reviews, so we don't have to worry about that. I picked this one up recently. It is an ICM reissue with Tamiya accessories. I love military kits. This one is the German Armored Railway Vehicle P204F version, and it comes with railroad tracks in the kit and figures, 1/35th military scale. You know I love weathering up military stuff, so eventually I'm going to be making a little diorama with this, with the track and everything, and we're going to go through a video on how to do that, because I don't just build Musulkov. I like to build everything, and military kits are a lot of fun, and usually a Tamiya ICM effort. They go together very well. You saw that howitzer kit that I built between these two companies when they re-released it, and it was absolutely gorgeous, and that's what I'm going to be doing with this one, making a little diorama out there. For the sci-fi lovers, Star Trek, the NCC-1701 refit with battle damage decals included. It doesn't have the Aztec, but it does have the battle damage, and I am completely fine with that. It's a press fit kit. I don't really need the Aztec decals on my kit. I like the old school Star Trek building without them. When they include them, I use them, but the battle damage being in there and everything else, and then I can just paint it up and do it as I want. It's 12 inches long, 40 pieces. It's an excellent kit. It's been out before, so we're going to get to take a look at it again. The 65 Chevelle by AMT. Special feature, screened windshield, all tires are pre-leaded, floater tire included, and vintage packaging. So that's pretty cool. You can see the options on the box there. That is excelente. Check it out. We got that floater tire. They got the racing wheels. We got the 454, big block, roll cage, roll bars, bucket seats with belts. So that's going to be a fun kit. You know, I like building those stocker cars. The Pirates kits. There's still more Pirates kits to come. I was so excited when I heard about it. Escape the Tentacles of Fate, sent over by Round 2. Available right now. Places like Model Roundup. It is awesome. It's underneath the Lindberg name. It's molded in glow and dark. Of course, I'll be painting it. Check it out. It's got the octopus bones, breaking action of the chain with the rubber bands that I like doing. And it's got the nice wood base in the barrel. You know, I get a big kick out of weathering all that up. It's got that nice ship's anchor. We're going to have a blast building this. And of course, like all the rest, it's got the bonus medallion. I'm waiting for the rest of those pirate kits to come out. And I'm waiting for the rest of the Haunted Mansion stuff to hit the ground. Coming out soon from MPC, Snap Fit 33 Willys Panel Van. This one done in a Monopoly motif. I can't wait to see the decals in the box. Check them out. All the different Monopoly motifs. There's a pre-built model of it. This thing's going to be a lot of fun. A quick, easy build with awesome details and the go-to-jail card and everything on there. Yes, definitely, definitely requested that. Check out all the cool stuff on there. And if you don't want to build it with the MPC Monopoly theme, just go build it as a regular panel van dragster car and have fun with it. Don't be so prejudiced against Snap-Tite kits. The 66 Chevy Modified Stocker. Get it on there. This one's got screened windshield, pre-lettered racing tires, updated decal sheet, and the nice vintage packaging, just like the other one. We won't be building these right on top of each other, so we'll get a little bit of a break. But I love these kind of race vehicles. This one's got the 427 in it. Got the grilled screen, side bodyguards. Absolutely outstanding. Crack that one open. From Revell, Germany, I picked up the HMS Revenge. I love sailing ships. This is small enough at only 16 centimeters long and 1/350th scale. I'll be able to put this together on the channel, weather it. You saw how nice the Pirates of the Caribbean easy click ship went together. And then I rigged it, made it look nice. I'll do the same with the HMS Revenge. 67 parts molded in multiple colors, which will make weathering easier. And we'll have a blast putting that bad boy together on the show for you. Don Perdome Winds Winder Top Fuel Dragster, the Snake Don Perdome. That actually speaks for itself. It's his dragster. It's got the full tube chassis, the full body in one piece or two pieces. We got that big 426 mil underneath the hood. We got some nice action picks so you can paint it up just like the real thing. Let me run over to the other side of the desk because that stuff is way over there and I can't reach it. The last two kits up, the 1966 Buick Wildcat. You can build this thing one of three ways. It's going to have the custom wheels, custom parts, decal sheet with that vintage packaging. Check out all the cool extra parts that'll be in there for you. So you can feel free to build this up any way you want and have fun with it. We'll be cracking that one open soon. And build progress right now while I'm working on this video. I'm working on the 32 scale 32 Ford. Say 32 one more time. It's 32. V8 coupe, three window from the Scale Stars. I didn't know this until I received this kit, but these were also built so that they could be used with slot car sets. And that's what made them so popular. But I'm in the middle of building it right now. You can see that cool decal sheet. It'll be one of the videos coming up most haste, probably within the next week or so of the airing of this video, you will see the 32 Ford in your face. So that is all the stuff that I've got on the bench for now. There's even some other stuff behind me that I didn't bring out that wouldn't even fit. That'll be a little bit of surprise here and there. But have fun. Enjoy the quarantine. If you can enjoy it, stay healthy. Enjoy the videos, and we'll be back with some more content.